love me, I bring the freedom, but I can't feel me, and I can't let them breathe. Bless when the tears come. Welcome back, guys. Thanks for clicking on this video. I didn't know how to make or start this video. Why's my dog paranoid? Mia! I just wanted to get on to the camera and talk about what happened after the Leafs won. So me and my friend Christian decided to get some late night food in Toronto because Mississauga food places close at 12. Yeah, we went to Toronto, got some food, it was a great time. On the way back, I got into a major accident. Like mid-accident, thinking I was gonna lose my life. And just everything happened so quickly, I didn't know what to do, what to expect. I was just trying to control the car. I don't really want to bore you or really tell you how the accident happened. All you need to know is that it was a huge lesson, but the reason you clicked on this video is because I wanted to tell you about the lessons I've learned from this accident. What did this accident teach me, and what did almost losing my life really teach me? The biggest thing that I probably learned was not to take life for granted, because When you're on that like adrenaline rush of like going through something and not knowing if you're gonna make it out alive, you really see how precious life is and how easy it is for us to, as like humans, like we're not immortals. When you understand that, you know that we're easily, like, we're fragile beings, honestly. Going through that, like, just really, really opened my eyes to how fragile we are and how to not take life for granted, because in the split of a second, in a blink of an eye, one second you're alive, the next, like, you might not be. So that's, like, the biggest thing that I took away from it was to protect, in a way, my life. The second thing I'd say is not chase the quick adrenaline rushes, not chase the 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 seconds of pleasure if the risk doesn't really outweigh the reward. That would be the next thing. It's not ever worth getting like a quick strike of fun if the risk could be way worse than that. Like now knowing what I know, like I would never really go seek something for pleasure that isn't worked hard for. Like I realize now that the best pleasures in life come from like hard work and like dedication and like seeing the results, like delayed gratification at the most. And I honestly, I'm not the biggest adrenaline junkie, but I definitely am, like, some to a degree, like I chase like those highs in life. But I would say, knowing what I know now, that chasing those quick highs is never worth it, especially if those quick highs aren't, nothing's really guaranteed, but I want to say a guaranteed return from that high moment. The next thing that I really learned is how God will try to use others to teach you and send messages towards you before he strikes his message. And when he strikes his message, it's real. It's real powerful, and it's not just a couple of words like he sends others to do. My girlfriend would always assure me and say, listen, driving is a dangerous thing. You gotta make sure you're driving safe, drive safe, drive safe, drive safe, right? And same as other people. But not that I wasn't a safe driver, but I wouldn't say I was careless, but I let driving really get over my head, and thinking that, oh, you have whatever, I don't even know, 5-6 years of experience now. You think, okay, I'm not the best in the world, but I've experienced, like, realistically nothing's gonna touch me. Like, I'm invincible on the roads, to quote unquote say, but you really aren't. And when an airbag and whatever else smacks you while you're driving in the middle of a highway, then you really get the message across and understand what God was really trying to tell you when he doesn't humble you with words. Let's just put it that way. God does not humble you with words. He humbles you with circumstances and scenarios. Lastly, it's the most important thing is what really mattered in those moments. I wasn't really caring about like money, fame. You don't really care about, oh, is my video blowing up, or oh, do I look good? Yeah, the things you think you care about through a day-to-day life, when those moments happen, like you really, those are the last things that are even, or they're not even on your mind. The biggest thing that was going through my mind is, I hope I don't hurt anybody. I hope everything's all right. I hope everybody around me is, I hope I learn from this. I hope I told my parents enough times that I love them. I hope that I hugged my loved ones. Just like, I hope my dog doesn't miss me. Like when I came back and I saw my dog so excited, I was like, oh my goodness, like this is those little things in life that you take for granted throughout the day. Those are the things that at the end of the day really matter, because those are the things that you can't live without. Like whatever, a car is always going to be replaceable. Like materialistic items, materialistic things, like even though they're nice, they do bring joy. Like I'm a huge car guy and I always will be, and my next car will probably also be a BMW. Congrats to those engineers, they knew what they were doing, but those things don't matter. Like they bring, like I said earlier, like momentary pleasure, momentary like dopamine. But at the end of the day, like what matters is like friendship. Like my friends were worried, my parents were worried, my girlfriend was worried, and like those are the people that like I didn't want to let down, or like I wanted to live another day for, like to see them, my dogs, my brothers, my sister. Like those are the days I looked, or those were the things that were going from my mind to look forward to. Like, I hope I could survive this accident just so I can get to see them one more time, or communicate with them one more time. Moral of this message, take a second in your life throughout the day, and if you're ever stressing or worrying, just how crazy it would be, just like imagine yourself if you were about to die, what would you really be going through your mind, what would you really be caring about? Because those are the things you should be focusing on, and those are the things that you should be building and compounding to create more joy and more happiness in your life, because that brings long-term happiness and pleasure, not short-term. As an example, if you have a relationship with somebody, you're always happy to see that person. Like I have these friends that, like, anytime I see them, I'll go back to them any moment, and every time I see them, it's just a great smile on my face, like seeing these people, seeing and spending time and exchanging energy just always brings me a happy smile. But like a materialistic item, like let's say a new car, right? I get my new car, the first week it's great, like even like a Lambo, let's say like I was to get a Lambo, like the first week it would be great, the feeling of it, the driving of it, the just even while I have it, I work so hard to get it, right? But over time, like materialistic things like tend to fade away with like happiness, and that's why we chase the next thing, bigger house, faster car, more expensive car, because like it just like more clicks of happiness and happiness. That's why it's really important to really truly sit down with yourself and figure out what brings you happiness. Because the biggest thing that I was taught was what brings me happiness and what is worth living another day for. We're back, better than ever, bigger mission, bigger purpose, and yeah, just hopefully keep this channel growing, keep you guys entertained, bring as much knowledge to you guys, and yeah. As always, stay blessed. God bless. Peace. Took everything, ain't nothing left. Count your blessings, count your stuffs.